Hello, welcome to Bay of Fundy Fortunes. My name is Natalie, and I'm here to do the mid-month reading for the sign of Leo the Lion. If I can ever get organized, it's Monday, okay? Enough said. It's just been one of those days. All right, so you're going to get right into your shuffle here now that everything's been cleansed and hopefully feel better in a minute. Smudges really picked me up. Okay, so for those of you who are new, 5-card spread. First card is your overall energy. Second card is your finances, wealth. Third card, your hearth, your home, your intimate love and relationships. Fourth card are your challenges, should there be any. Leo, fifth card is your message from spirit. I'm going to come up with another new spread for these mid-month readings. I get bored doing the same one over and over again, so we're going to change things up. Okay. I'll cut the deck then. Jeez Louise. And I'll consult with my pendulum Lilith to see if these are indeed the cards meant for your spread, Leo. As this deck stands, Lilith, of the top 5 cards, the cards are meant for the Leo general free public reading for mid-February, 15th on through the end of the month, 2019. Are these the cards that are meant for the Leo general reading? Well, I'm getting a, yeah, yes, all right. When she shifts like that a little bit, it means, yeah, that's, I hate the thought that I might be influencing it. That's why I always brace my hands. I see a lot of other people use the pendulum and they hold it like that, but their hands are going, maybe they don't know they're doing it. Maybe they think their hand isn't doing that. All right. Very first card, Leo. Overall energy. Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. For the rest of the month, from the 15th on, phenomenal. Whoops, I normally, there, we pull the camera down. Second card, your wealth and your finances. The Two of Cups. What I got right off of that right away is somebody's making money, but they're flipping bored to tears with the job or the way they're making money. Third card, Five of Wands, competition. This is in your hearth, your home, relationships, intimate love. Fourth card, your challenges. You got the King of Pentacles, trust. Your next card, card number 5, your message from spirit. Ooh, geez, I should reshuffle, but I never do that. I keep to the integrity of the spread. It can't always be cards that we welcome into a reading. They can't all be 100% good. It is what it is. The good thing about this is it is a general reading. Some of this is going to apply to some of you and other people. No, it won't. That's just the way the general readings go. And no smart-ass remarks either about, that's a way to keep you safe. To say that one might not apply to everybody. That sounds fake to me. Really, I don't even argue with that mentality. See ya, boom, you're gone. So, anyway, Leo, oy vey. Like, you've got three, I call them yucky. Three yucky cards. Doesn't normally happen. Are you breaking the good streak here? Oh. The good thing is, you've got this beautiful card for your overall energy. It's the Ace of Swords. It's all about coming out on top. Victory. Winning something. Succeeding. Seeing something through to the very end and going, yes, I did it. It does. Even though it's just one card. The fact that it's an ace, that's beautiful. It lessens the degree of the Four of Cups, the Five of Wands, and the Three of Swords. It lessens the negativity. It chases away a few shadows, put it that way. They still don't bode well. But anyway, with the Ace of Swords, the main thing with this card, is this card brings extreme clarity up here. Swords are air signs. It's all about what's going on in your head. But it brings extreme clarity, which means, okay, you're seeing the truth of something or somebody for the very first time. It's like the lights weren't on and boof, floodlights everywhere and you can see everything. There's no shadows. They're not hiding. They can't hide. But you're seeing, just getting that clarity. For some of you, other people, you're making a decision on what to do. You finally reach a decision on what to do. You've been mulling it over. You've been, you know, wrestling with some kind of a situation and or a decision that you had to make. Oh, here we go. Not so much the itchy nose anymore or the itchy upper lip. No, it doesn't mean I have a mustache. The vibrational energy is coming through from the reading. Now the new thing is yawning. I haven't yawned all day. And the minute I turn this camera on, it's just annoying. This card brings, it sees you making some really smart choices that are going to be really good for you. Okay? And you're even going to have some breakthroughs. Things that you've been looking for answers or information is going to come to you, and you'll probably get way more than what you bargained for. This is a card about new beginnings in romance. And as I said, sharp mental clarity. Oh my God, come on. Ugh. Indecision making, logical decisions, hardcore decisions. Use the intellectual side of your brain. Tap into your intellect. Making emotional decisions, you go to the other side and you tap in from the emotional side of your brain where your feelings reside. And try not to blur the lines between the two because they'll weaken the other. It will weaken either side. So try to not, because it really does make an influence. If you had a logical, technical, you know, kind of a situation and you're all emotion, your emotions are coming into it. That weakens that. You can't think clearly. You can't make a real clean decision. But this card takes care of that for you. Your keywords for this card are beginnings and decisions. Action. Love that word. Clarity. Ideas. And finding solutions to some things that may have plagued you for a little while. So this card overall is your energy. Making progress, spill it, give it to me, making progress, and also accomplishments that you will reach by the end of the month. That's a big thing. I knew there was something else to squeeze out of there. Accomplishment. You got some stuff done in February. A load off for some of you. You feel the load lifting off your shoulders. And now you're looking more forward to March than you were a couple weeks ago. Four cups and boredom. Oh, somebody is. There's nothing worse. I don't get bored. Oh my gosh. Take a look around me. There's always something to do. You wouldn't believe how behind I am on stuff. It's amazing. And today I said, okay, this is getting a little embarrassing now, so I gotta take care of these little things. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. You go, okay, she's nuts. It's not that bad. Oh, all right, I've not been feeling well. I've been tired. I celebrated my Christmas late, and I'm a Christmas freak. I love it. My tree's still up. It is still up. I still have a real poinsettia right here behind the camera. All my lights are on. It's like I felt resentful because I didn't get to enjoy Christmas the way I normally would because I was in the hospital, blah, blah, blah. And I look at that tree and it brings my mood up. It's beautiful. It makes me happy. And it's kind of stubborn too. This is my world. This is my home. I'll take the damn tree down when I feel like it. But I did say to somebody today, okay, it's getting embarrassing now. It's time to put it away. Time to put some stuff away, which I never got to today. Today's Monday. So anyways, I don't even know why I started telling you that. It's just gone. But somebody here, this message is directed at a few of you. Oh, about five of you is the number that's coming through. This is a card where that comes up when some people are starting to slide into a depression, get into a funk. And it's all about not enjoying anything anymore. It's all old. It's all boring. It's stagnant. There's no growth. There's no nothing. There's never gonna be nothing. That's the attitude. That's the feeling. Why would there ever be? There hasn't been in a long time. I don't believe in anything anymore. I just don't. There's the attitude, right? And maybe you have good reason. But the truth of the matter is, as much as most of us don't want to admit this, we don't want to work that hard for what it is we want, for one thing. It'd be nice to have a break once in a while and have just something come in for no good reason. Maybe a burst of color in the world, something. Your world is gray. And you're bored with your work. And the money may be good, and the money is steady. If nothing else, it's steady money coming in, steady work. But you don't even care anymore. You have to find new inspiration to pop you back into the land of the living, to give you a surge of interest and excitement and life within you to bring yourself back. Go out and do something different. Go someplace you've never been before. Go around people that are nothing like you. Take in places that you maybe walked by 1,000 times and never ever gave it a second thought. Go in there and check it out. You can't be inspired. You can't have zest for life and energy for life. Not the way mainstream people do anyway. Everybody finds their own happy place, but it's an unfortunate fact of life. Even if you don't like people, you need them. You need the sounds of life around you. Otherwise, you just fall into this gray world. And what to tell you about this? If it's that bad, you're thinking of your bottom line. What happens if I leave this job? And you're thinking of your money, your income. You don't leave one till you go to another, right? You find another job quicker. As they say, if you're already at a job, you'll find another one faster. Why? I don't know. I've never thought of the logic to it. But anyway, that's what they say. Somewhere something's going to break for you, Leo. All right? Something has to break to pull you back into society, into some social circles, to make you feel alive again. You talk to the universe, ask for a little bit of help there. But mostly these kind of things, they're all on you. You're feeling so far down that you need to reach up to touch bottom. That's pretty sad. So you need to get that straightened away, all right? Then worry about your money flow. Right now, you're safe, but it's empty. Do you know what I mean? It's empty. You feel empty. All this money coming in, and you feel empty. Lo and behold, give me them problems. No, I'm just being smart. Anybody's feeling depressed or anything like that, well, hey, you have my sympathy, my empathy. So I don't get real quiet, kind of depressed. I don't know. Just must be in my blood. But I don't get like that. I get real vocal. I don't like what's going on. It pisses me off. I get angry. I get vocal. You know, I'm the type of person I can't hold that stuff in all the time. Otherwise, it burns a hole in my stomach. The minute I vent my things out, my problem, I feel fine. The burning goes away. Everything settles back down. Nothing may have changed, but I just feel better for venting. God Almighty. Sorry. We're not all cut from the same cloth. We are all one, but we're all unique and we're very different in how we deal with things and how we handle things. Some of us are very quiet and hold everything in, and maybe that works for you. I do that, and it just I'm just like eating my guts from the inside out. I can't stand I'm an expressive person, excitable personality sometimes, but I'm an expressive person. So, having said that, this is a card about competition and tasks. You know, I think your own competition right here is yourself, and applying things that you want, bringing things into your life, into your reality, into your now, is for some of you a little bit overwhelming. You don't have the mental energy to apply yourself. See, you are gone further than the four cups. That's gone beyond. You feel like you're being tested every. Ooh, okay. Somebody's suffering from paranoia. You're paranoid. Competition. And you feel that there is competition out there, and you take it personal because you believe it's all against you. Take a deep breath. Walk away from that for a bit. All right. And come back and look at it again. I think I already said this once today to somebody. You get paranoid much? You know. If you're not careful, somebody could come along and say to you, how vain are you? You think everything's all about you? It's not about you. They'd be right. I don't know about the vanity, but they'd be right about the rest of it. It's not all about you, Leo. Stop putting yourself in the center of negative attention. Be thankful to not be there. This card is one of competition, and it's one of test, and it's one of, oh, being overwhelmed. You feel like nobody's listening to you. They're not hearing you. They're not seeing you. This could be an actual thing that's happening. It's not your imagination, because we all go through those little times where our friends, people we work, and it all happens with, like, it's like this big stamp comes down over your life, and it's like you're not there. And everyone's affected by it around you. So is it just you? Or is it them? I believe it's just the energies that come in sometime. Thank goodness they're short-lived, a couple days at most. And you're feeling kind of all alone in the world after day one or two. Nobody's heard a word I said all day. Nobody even looked my way today. And those that did look in my direction looked right through me. What the hell? It happens. Not just to you, Leo. It happens to everybody from time to time. At times like that, the way to get through it kind of preoccupies your mind a little bit. Be more of an observer rather than a participant of everything going on around. Just sit back and watch. Sit back and watch everybody. I love people watching. This is a card about pretending to be something that you're not. This card always refers to that as posturing or pretending you're somewheres, or you've just got something, or you're just trying to put it out there like, I'm all good. It's all good for me. I don't care what you think. I know I'm good. You know what I mean? There's just this pretending, and maybe inside you're crushed. Ego is a great big thing with this card as well, and you may clash egos with somebody else, Leo. Someone's pride could get hurt. There could be some debates, little spits of arguments going back and forth. A lot, you're feeling like you're really, really being tested these days. And your opinions don't, you're feeling like they don't count. The communications and ego are things that you need to watch with this card. The big thing with this card is it affects you at home as well. This is going on everywhere. Your family, your friends, your work. It's going on everywhere. You're lucky you can even get attention at the coffee counter at your favorite coffee shop to order coffee that they don't look right through you. You know, it's that kind of thing. This too shall come to pass. It only lasts a couple of days. Your fourth card, in a long reading. Fourth card is your, yeah, you wouldn't. Oh, why is this reading like this? All this no trust, a twisted way of looking at things, seeing things from another angle that normal, regular, everyday people don't. There's some paranoia. There's some distance. There's some self-pitying going on. Leo, I'm sorry. I've never had a reading like this for Leo before, ever, for any sign. There's this sense of self that it's too much. You live in a world, you live in a society, in a community, in a neighborhood. You reside within a family structure and unit. Think of the logic when I say this. It cannot always be all about you. I don't know where this reading is coming from. Wow. And you know, trust, these are your challenges. Your challenge is going to be to learn to trust again, trust for the first time, allowing trust into your life, making a human connection with somebody else, special things that you share, that you talk about, this sort of thing. Oh my gosh, Leo. I'm glad this is a general reading though. It doesn't apply to everybody because I'd go click. I'd just shut it off. This is crazy. Geez, thank goodness it's only the last half of the month. You have to work at being more committed to the relationships in your life. You have to give as much as you take. All right? You really do. Some of you haven't been doing that. It's been take, 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 me, me, me. Not everybody. If anybody leaves a comment saying, I'm not like that, I'm never like that, I don't think that way, it's not about you, it's general reading, even more so. So don't freaking message me and say something so stupid. You don't feel protected. You don't trust. You don't feel protected. You feel like you're wide open and everybody's out to get you. There's a lot of paranoia going on. I don't know why. You know what? One way to pull your head out of your own, right, is you get out, whether you like it or feel it or not, you get out and go do something for others. Give back. Go volunteer. Go help anybody that needs help. When we get out of our own lives and we step out like that, that can make big differences. When you come back in, you don't feel the same as when you first left. And that's the truth. How could you be? Helping others, it's the ultimate gift if you're able to help others. You say, well, I'll be a gift to them, not me. No, it is a gift to you too. Huge gift. Think about that. Food for thought. Money, success brings rewards. You got a lot of working on yourself to do, Leo. I like Leos. This is nothing personal. It really isn't. It only applies to so many people. And the last card is your message from spirit. I have, oh This card. It's haunting me this week for some reason. This is a transient card. There's transition coming for somebody, or you've just been through it. Whatever it is, you will heal from this. You will process it. You will heal from it. This card's usually related to breakups and affairs of the heart. My goodness. Disappointments. The upside to this card, if somebody has messed around on you, you split up, they were having an affair, anything like that, the positive side to this card is now you see the truth. There's no more turning your head away, looking the other way, lying to yourself. That's normal stuff, by the way. Okay, nothing wrong with you there. You're going to know where you stand with your partner, the other person opposite you. You're going to know where you stand. And this card can bring, and it can, you know, put it out there to say that some of you are suffering from anxiety and fear that signifies that you're very, very, very stressed. The advice of this card is to see the truth, feel the pain. This is all happened for a reason. Your keywords are heartbreak and sorrow, betrayal, loss, affairs, breakup, and tears. I'm so sorry, Leo. I really, really, you know what, Leo, I feel so bad, and I don't care where you're at, 28 minutes, those that don't like long videos, piss off somewhere. God, there's other readers out there, put me to shame, 45 minutes, an hour and 10 minutes, I mean, gosh, I want to know if there's anything good coming for Leo during the last half of February, please. Is there any good coming for Leo at all? I know it should have shown up there. The first card was beautiful. Could we have one more? Could we have one more? Oh, God, they're stupid tonight. I'm going to cut the deck and see what comes up. The High Priest. You know what I got off of this right off, Leo? This time period, the last half of the month, it's all about learning for you. Getting more wisdom, seeing the light in a manner of speaking, but you will move forward because you're learning, and he's in your corner. He's the teacher card. Okay. He's the teacher of tarot, and he offers, you can see his right hand, offered an extension to help you, to teach you, to guide you. All good things from this card. That's just, I'm not going to argue with tarot anymore. Thank you very much for being here. If you like this reading, you can read down below this video window in the show more section. And if you want something personal, also thank you everybody for being here. I hope you got something from the reading. I don't normally do readings like that. I don't normally get readings like that. They don't come in that way. So Leo, wow, sorry. You'll get through it like everything else. One thing about Leo, you're very resilient. You're very emotional, but you're resilient. You always bounce back. You're going to pull yourself together soon enough. If you'd like to, for those of you that do not hate Facebook, please join us there under groups, Bay of Fundy Fortunes. Closed, private, and beautiful. Moving on. If anybody's looking for me, you don't find me here. I'm always sitting and looking out at the Bay of Fundy out in my backyard. I keep all my attention most of the day, especially if I'm alone, is looking out the window or pet walking. I just love the tides. They're fantastic here. No matter where you find me, you'll always catch me waiting on the next tide. And the Bay of Fundy as well. We call this, I call it the eight wonders of the world, the eighth wonder of the world. And it was in the running for that. It was. A few years back, I never made it. I can't remember which one was, but they were in the running for it, the tides here in the Bay of Fundy. What was I going to say to that? Now I forget. Trying to find my feet again is what I'm trying to do here. I've had a really rough day. But anyway, keep the peace on so you can share the love and the light out with the rest of the world. Leo, it's going to get better, and I'm very sorry about the reading, but it is what it is. I never reshuffle. I try, you know what? If I had, I bet you the same cards more or less would have all come up because it's happened too many times. That's why I don't do it. Universe speaks, I listen. So should you. I'll see you all back here in March. I hope. Bye for now.